Let's make an explosive text using a single simulation effect which was introduced back in 1996 and still holds to this day. Alright, we're going to start with one of the biggest buttons in the interface, new composition. I'll name this composition Explode Text. This is the preset I'm using and the duration is 5 seconds. I'll click OK. Then I'll double click on the rectangle tool, which is going to create a shape layer. I'm using a gradient fill. Black is on one side and some sort of a navy blue on the other. I'm just going to drag it like so. And then I'll name this guy BG to avoid the bending phenomena. We can add some noise to this layer and set it to maybe a value of 5 or 6 and also check off color noise. All right, I'm also going to convert it to 3D as well as make sure that I'm using the classic 3D engine. For this one, you don't need the Cinema 4D or the advanced 3D renderer. Okay, next thing is to double click on the horizontal type tool, and this is going to create an empty text layer in the middle of the frame. I'll type in the name of one of my favorite bands, Massive Attack. I'll press Command A, Control A on Windows to select everything. And I forgot to capitalize the letters, but I can press Command Shift and K. This will be Control Shift and K to capitalize them. While I'm here, let me just share with you that Command Shift L is flash left and Command Shift R is flash right. Just in case you want to use keyboard shortcut for this arrangement, I'm actually going to press Command Shift C to make it center again. You can also do it from the paragraph panel. I'll raise the text to 300 and then I'm going to double click on the word attack and change it from regular to let's go with something black, which will make the contrast between the first and second line even more apparent. And then I'm just going to scale it so it will be more or less block aligned. While I'm here, I'll hold down the Option Alt key on Windows and then using the Up cursor key, I'm just going to nudge this title up, almost touching the upper word. And then I'll approve my creation. I'm also going to change the fill. So I'll select, let's say, an orange color, and I'll also set a stroke color. And this should be white. It's very important. You will see why in a moment. I'll set the pixels to 10, and I think this is going to work for our purposes. Notice that you have a few options here. So you can go with fill over stroke, stroke over fill over all strokes, or all strokes over all fills, which is what I'm going to select in this case. Now I'll select the text, go to the effect menu, and from the simulation category, I'll apply the shatter effect. Now, a bit of history in case you're interested. This shatter effect, developed by Brian Moffat of Atomic Power Corporation, was introduced in 1996 as part of the Evolution plugin set for Adobe After Effects. And then Adobe later acquired Atomic Power and integrated shatter and other plugins into After Effects. What I like mostly about the shatter effect, believe it or not, is right-clicking on the name shatter and choosing About. And this is going to tell you that it's going to blow stuff up. Also, here is the credit of Brian Moffat. Anyhow, I'm going to change it from wireframe and forces to rendered. And then for the shape, I'll set the pattern to custom and I'll reference the text itself. And now if I'll preview the comp, you can see how this works. All right, we can control some stuff here. First, I'll check white tiles fixed. And this is going to leave the white tiles on screen. And again, I just want to remind you that everything is still editable. So if you want to change the way the text is rendering, you can set it, let's say, to all fills over all strokes. And this is going to leave just a thinner line, which I think works better in this case. I'm also going to change the extrusion depth because the shatter effect will automatically extrude the shape that it is breaking. So let's go with 0.6 and we can also control the appearance of the side by changing the texture over here. So I'll start by sampling a different color. Let's go with something like this and maybe make it a bit more bright. And then for the side mode, instead of layer, I'll set it to color, which is going to give it this appearance. Okay, we are going somewhere, but I think we need to control the forces. I don't want it to explode immediately, maybe after 10 frames or so. So I'll place the current time indicator where I want the explosion to start, open up force number one, I'll close the textures for now, and then we can play with the radius. So I'll set the radius to zero, and this means that basically I'm turning off the explosion part. I'll create a keyframe over here, and then I'll move one frame forward by pressing page down and set it to, say, 0.3. And again, previewing from the beginning, you can see nothing is changing. And then we have the inner part of the text exploding, leaving behind the stroke of the text. You can also control the strength of the explosion. Let's tone it down to 3. So this looks like this. And instead of the pieces falling down, I'll close force number one. By the way, you have additional force if you want to, but in this case, I'm just going to play with the physics. So I'll change the gravity to 0. And then we can also play with the randomness. So let's set it to 0.4, tab to the viscosity and change it to 0.15. And then we can play again from the beginning. And because this is basically rendering in real time, you can have a sense how this looks. Now you can also control the rotation speed. So maybe let's set this one to a faster speeding rotation, something like this. So pieces are going to fly all over the place. And of course, anytime you are playing with the shape itself, for example, if I'm going to scale it, you're probably going to get a different variation. So I found out that the best way to get some variation from this effect is just to change the scale. And this is because the shutter effect creates a threshold map and uses it to extrude and create the explosion. But it's not finished yet. We can control many other things, such as, for example, the lighting. We can use the built-in distance source, or we can use the first comp light, or just to make things simple, I'm going to use the point source option. So you can play with the light position and just place the position of the light in different places and see how this works for you. So maybe something like this. Again, playing it from the beginning is going to give us the intermediate result. All right, I'll close the lighting and I'll open up the camera position. This effect comes with a built-in camera, which will allow you to change it in 3D space and control the way it appears. But I think the easiest way to work is to change the camera system to the comp camera, which of course will respond to a composition camera. So I'll go ahead to the layer menu and create a new camera. You can pick whatever preset you want. I'll stick with 35mm and click OK. And now I can use the After Effects built-in camera tools. By holding down Option, I can use my 3-button mouse to orient as well as dolly and move the camera to where I like it to be. I'll undo and let's just try to art direct it. So we know that the explosion starts at 10 frames, so actually 11 in our case. So we'll need to introduce the text within the first 10 frames. So to achieve it, I'll create keyframes for the point of interest and position, then go to the beginning. I'll hold down the Option key and with the right mouse, I'm just going to zoom into the letters. Now, because I'm zoomed so far, I can't see the background. So what I need to do is return to the background, press P to show its position, and I'm just going to move it back until I'll see the background again. All right, something like this should work. And now I can move my current time indicator, and obviously I need to scale the background as well. And because now that we are scaling it, we may need to also edit the gradient, but we'll leave it for later. For now, I just want to continue my camera move. So I'll go all the way to the end and then I'll continue to pull back. And then I want to orbit the scene, but I want to orbit around the center of my comp. So I can press Shift-1 to switch between the tools that we have here. So the default one is orbit around the cursor tool. I actually want to orbit around the scene tool, and Shift-1 is going to do it for me. And this, in this case, is going to give me a bit more control to be exactly where I want to be. So something like this, Maybe also zoom in a little bit more tighter. So again, this is some sort of a ping pong game until you find the result that you're after. I'm scanning also the background and then go to the beginning and see how everything works together. So this is what we've got so far. And maybe I want to smooth the motion. Instead of pressing F9, which is the default for most users, which is going to create some sort of a halt. You can see the keyframes here. If we're looking at the graph editor, basically it stops and then it starts to move again. So I'll return back to the regular keyframes view. I'll undo maybe twice, and then I'll hold down Command Control on Windows and click on the keyframes to convert them to auto bezier. And this means that the spatial motion now is going to be continuous. And this is what it means. We have the same velocity going into and out of the keyframes, meaning that the result is going to be much more nicer, which is what I and you want. All right, so now all we need to do is just control the gradient, make sure that we can see it. So I'll zoom out, return to the selection tool, make sure that I'm selecting the rectangle so I can see this little heads-up display, and then I can bring it a little bit more closer to us. And we do want to maybe add some shadows. So let me show you what else you can do. So hopefully you can see that some of the letters are basically overlapping the outline of the text. And this is something that we can fix using the shatter effect. It is a very capable effect. So what we need to do is change the render mode from all to layer and pieces. I'll start with layer, and this is just going to render the layer without the explosion part. And to this instance, by the way, I can add its own effect. I'll choose to add the radial shadow effect. I'll set the softness to 100 and the opacity to the same value. And this is giving us something that looks like this. And of course, we can move the shadow. We can place it wherever we want. I think something like this will work. And now I'll duplicate this layer, and I'm going to change the render to pieces. And this is just going to render the pieces on top of the original one. And now they are not colliding with each other. And at the same time, this gives us the option to modify the radial shadow on its own. So maybe at the beginning here, we want the projection distance to be something very close, maybe 1. And then we can animate it all the way to the end and start to move it. So the shadows are going to move with the letters. Now, this is totally fake, but again, it just needs to look convincing or good enough. The only thing which is missing here is some motion blur. This effect is so old, it doesn't support motion blur. So even if you're enabling it, nothing is going to happen. And to remedy this, I'll add an adjustment layer. And to this adjustment layer, I'll apply the CC force motion blur effect. And I'll set the motion blur samples to 16 and check how this looks in few places. So maybe over here, I need to actually place this adjustment layer above all the other layers, otherwise it won't render. So you can see how this works. Now, just to top things up, I'll go back to the noise and grain category, and I'll add additional noise. This time it's going to be the noise HLS auto. So I'll add it to the same adjustment layer, change the noise to grain, and change the lightness to, let's go with 4 and see how this looks, just to eliminate the bending, maybe even less. 3 should be enough, even with the heavy YouTube compression. All right, all we need to do right now is just add some sound effects, and we can preview the result. Because we have 2 copies, if you need to change the text, you need to make sure that you are changing both of them. So let me show how this works. I'll double click on the word massive after soloing this layer and type in power, and then double click on attack, type in station, and also double click on the word power again, make it a bit bigger just so it will look a bit more nicer. And then I'll select everything, copy it to the clipboard, double click on the second layer, and then paste it, and now we have a different per character text exploding. Let's go to the start, maximize this, and preview again. If you want to download this project file, there's a link down below. If you enjoyed it, make sure to like and subscribe, and I will see you again next time.